this is an instrument that is quartz crystal microbalance. So this instrument will give the real-time adsorption of a substrate molecule on the surface. So this is one of the most efficient instrument to give the adsorption on surface. For the real-time adsorption of the surface, that for each particular time what adsorption is taking place on any of the surface will get determined using this instrument. So we'll see what are all the parts of these instruments. So at very first, this is the QCM. This is the actual equipment. This is pump from which sample will flow inside the this flow module. So this flow module, these two are the important part of the instrument. Inside this there is a flow module. So we will open this. This setup is called as flow module, and I will show you why it is called flow module. So if we will open this screw, so simply a screw attachment. So this is the crystal port. Here we will keep the crystal. Electrode will face here. The symbol is here. And the surface is below, downwards. So this setup is basically called flow module. If we will open this and we will see inside, there is a rubber kind of silicon kind of rectangular tubing is there. And in that there is flow of sample. This module is made up, is made on that that rectangle flow module. And from that the sample, from here we will keep the sample, and using this silicon tubing through this pump the sample will flow inside this flow module, and then the sample get adsorbed on the crystal, and then after flowing it will come out using the another outlet through this silicon tubing, that I will be explaining further in detail when we start the experiment. So this is the setup. The arrow should be on this side. And now the third, we have seen the crystal, we have seen the equipment. Now third thing is the software. So there are two software, QSoft and QTools. So QSoft is the software which will give you the real data from the instrument, and QTools is the analysis software. So once you will get data from QSoft, you can analyze that data in QTools, and you can extract the data in Excel sheet in Excel using this QTools. So now we will see how we will run the experiment in this QCM. So first we'll switch on the instrument from here. See, if you press it for 2 minutes, it will open. The green light should come. Then we'll switch on the pump. It should be switched on, and then we will open the software QSoft. We will open the software QSoft, and we have to see that it will establish the connection with the instrument. So if this star, this sensor acquisition, it will come, it means it has established the connection with the instrument. Now we will keep the sample, quartz crystal sample, and then we will run this experiment. So what we have to do, at very first we have to keep the crystal in this flow module. So first we will take out this flow module. We will open it. Now we can see this is a crystal. I'll show you what is the crystal. So this is a quartz crystal. This is actually a very delicate crystal, and it is quite expensive also. This one will cost 10,000 rupees. So what we have to see, this gold structure is there, that is the electrode. So we have to take care that our this is the crystal. We have to take care that electrode should not touch the tweezer should not touch the electrode, otherwise there's some scratches will come on the electrode and the signal we will get will not be clear. Now this is the surface. This is the surface. So this in the middle, that circle is there, that is the actual surface. It could be of many types. Like it could be of gold, it could be of silver, it could be of silica. So here this one is silica coated crystal. The surface is silica. So after washing and cleaning using the proper protocol, we have to first clean this crystal. We have to get it dried using nitrogen, and then we can keep this sample, this crystal here. So now we have to make sure there is a symbol of electrode. So we have to keep the crystal in such a way as the symbol is given, and electrode should be upward. So we have kept the sample, and now we will close it. Now we have to take care that we should not tighten it hardly, otherwise the crystal will break. So but we have to tighten it, we cannot keep it loose also, otherwise sample will flow out from here. So tighten it softly. Then this aroma should be on this side where we have to fit this silicon tube. So we'll keep it here. Now the sample will be kept here in this the sample will go through this silicon tubing. It will go from here to inside the flow module. So this arrow is for inside, and we have to fit this tubing here. Then the sample will be taken out from here and we will put it here. So we have to keep 1 meter for the discard, and so now we'll pour this silicon tubing inside the sample, and this is another beaker for the discard. Then we will close this flow module. Now another thing which we have to take care is that the output we'll get from this instrument is the frequency. When the molecule get bombarded at the electrode, there is frequency generated that we will be getting here in this QSoft software. So the space should be noise free, there should not be any noise, otherwise this frequency disturbance will happen. Now after putting this sample and putting this crystal and fitting all the requirements of the instrument, we'll see what is this pump. So pump is basically, it will give the flow rate at which the sample will go to the flow module. This 75 means 75 microliter per minute sample will go to the flow module. We can increase it also. It can go up to 1000, 10,000. Yes, it can go up to very high speed also, and it can go to very low speed. That depends, that varies from sample to sample. So now we have kept like 75 microliter per minute. Now the scale max, if we will press this reset, and we will see where the arrow is going. If the arrow is going this side, means this pump will move from here to here, which is not required. So we have to make sure that the arrow should always be on this side, that the sample, the pump will flow in this anti-clockwise direction, and the sample will go from here to the flow module into this curve. Rest other things are for the calibration of this pump. That is required at the time of calibration. Generally, it is not required at all. So, if we will start this run, the sample start flowing from here to the flow module at the rate of 74.7 microliters per minute. So, after switching on the pump, we'll go to acquisition. We will do setup measurement, and here we have to see whether the crystal is correct or not. For that, we need to have the frequency for all harmonics. There are different harmonics up to 11, so 5 different harmonics is there. We have to get the frequency signal for all the harmonics, then only we can start. Here there is a temperature control, so you can keep it like 22 or whatever the required temperature, and you just keep it applied. Then sensors. So here what we will do, we will do find and run. It means that for each harmonic, it will find the frequency of the crystal, and then the experiment starts and the sample starts running. So it's find and run, and it has all the samples. So from here we will get the signals. There is one frequency signal and there is one dissipation signal. If something is coming on the surface, then the frequency will start decreasing. And if something is going out of from the surface, then the dissipation will start increasing. That is, something is dissipated, some molecule is dissipating from the surface, or some molecule is adsorbing on the surface. So using this frequency itself, using the Sorbre equation, we can convert this frequency into mass. Mass adsorbed at that particular time on the surface. So initially there is some disturbance will come. But we have to run the, at first we have to run the blank or the buffer solution till the signal will become stable. Then again we can restart it from here and the measurement will start again. And then, or else if like the signal is stable, then we can keep the sample. We can change the sample from here to the different, suppose this is the blank buffer solution, then we can keep the whole this silicon tubing into the sample, and we can just write it here at what time we have changed the number of samples, or whatever be the sample, we can make a note here. After completion, you just have to stop the current. Suppose let's say the experiment is completed, so you have to stop it from here, and then you have to save it. Let's say for ABC, this whole data gets saved at in the QSoft instrument, in the QSoft software form. We can close it from here. So now the data is saved in the form of this QSense defined. In the form of the software data. So now how we will extract this data? So we will go to QTools, or there is another software also. So the software is QTools, and one more recent software is there, QSense Defined. So from this QC stipend also we can extract the data and we can do the fitting or subsequent analysis. So now we are doing it using Q2s. So we'll open this Q2s, then we'll go to file, open, and from here let's say suppose this is one data. So we will get all the values of all the harmonics using in this data. So for simply extracting, so now what all modification we can do here, we can either calculate the mass using Sorbrell equation, so that is automated here. We just click Sorbrell, right click here and click Sorbrell. Then here you want the aerial mass, that will come in nanogram per centimeter square. For which frequency you want, that you need to select. Like I want it for frequency 1/3 harmonic, for fifth harmonic, or like I want it for fifth harmonic. Then I will choose fifth harmonic. Let's say output will give M5, and then we'll calculate. And see here the mass or the mass has came for the fifth frequency. For this frequency, we got the mass. Now we can plot this data also. So see, generally this kind of graph will come. This is the frequency that is going down as the sample is absorbing, and this is dissipation. If something is coming out from the surface, then dissipation is increasing. The scale is here and here. So we will see the frequency is going till -17 around, and the dissipation is coming around 2. This is in hertz, and this value we will be calculating from this value we can calculate the mass, or we can show the dissipation we want to show. Now to extract this data, just go in. So we can extract the data. We'll go to file, export, and then in Excel file we want to save it. Then include column name, mass weight, and then we can save it. So the data is saved in Excel form. See, this is the data. We got the mass of 5. We got the each frequency and each dissipation. And then we can copy this in the any of the Excel sheet. And we can plot it. This is the T actual. That is the actual temperature that is observed in the instrument for each particular time, as we have set the temperature to 25 or 22 for this experiment is 22. So it cannot be exactly 22 all the time, so it is showing the exact temperature. So if you want to analyze, you can analyze this parameter also. That's it. This is the time in seconds, and this is all about the QCM. You can convert this frequency into the mass, and that will give you the real time absorption mass or change in mass on the surface before and after absorption. Thank you.